Hello and welcome to Gardening at 58 North. In this video I'm going to be adding a little bit more colour to my balcony for spring. These are the plants I'm going to be going with this spring. Now, ideally I would have actually planted up my spring flowers in the autumn time, but I was actually very busy last autumn. I kind of missed the deadline for when is a good time to plant for autumn bedding plants, so I'm having to do it now in spring. If I was to do it in autumn, I would have done a lot more. The reason I'm just doing a few this spring is because it won't be long until I'm planting the summer flowers, and I find if you do put plants out for spring, certainly here in Scotland, when it comes to putting out the summer flowers, you've probably got to wait until round about May, June time, and that's only going to be about a 2 month window of period when you can have spring flowers and before the summer flowers come in. Because if I plant these too early, the frost will kill them off, or if there's not any too hard a frost, certainly with the pansies, they can survive a bit of frost, they just won't have any flowers. So there's only really a 2 month window in Scotland where you can have nice spring flowers before it's time to put out your summer flowers. And if I left these to grow into June, the problem is these probably get powdery mildew. They might do okay, but then I'll be planting my summer flowers too late, and we have such short summers here in Scotland that it wouldn't really grow much and I wouldn't get much of a display for my summer flowers. So because of that reason, instead of doing my whole balcony in spring flowers just for 1 or 2 months, this will be very expensive considering I've got a lot of pots and they're only going to be in there for a couple of months. I'm just going to go with three different types of plants and a couple of tubs. So first of all, I'm going with some violas. So this one here, you can see it's got some nice different colours on it. You've got some very dark purple and some white. I quite like the two-tone colour violas like this. I find that they're just really nice to have the two different colours. The one I often go for is one called Coconut Duet, which is kind of similar to this. This one is, I think, called Cutie, and you can see it's got some purple blotches on the white section, which Coconut Duet doesn't have. And then the other one I have here is called Blackberry, and that's just a pure purple colour. The really, really nice kind of violet, very, very dark. So these are actually going to go in my two planters that sit on the railings of my balcony. You can probably just about see them down there at the corner of the table. I'll be planting them into that. Put one of these into each pot. And then my other plant I went for is the Senetti. I mean, I really love Senettis. Just the colour is absolutely spectacular. This one, again, it looks much more purple and violet in real life. But it's coming across as quite blue on the camera, but it's a really nice kind of colour. I might take some pictures to show you what it looks like. Hopefully the pictures, I can change the colour balance a little bit and you'll be able to see what it looks like more in real life as opposed to what the camera's picking up as. But this is a really healthy plant, one of the healthiest Senettis I've seen in the shop for a long time. Normally you get them covered in flowers, covered in buds, much smaller leaves, but this one, because it has so few flower buds at the moment, I know it's going to do really well for me, because what this means is it's going to have a longer flowering period. Often when I buy them in the shops, they're either covered in flower buds or they're already covered in flowers and they only last a few months. Whereas this one, it's only just starting to come into flower and there's several buds coming. And I know that further down here, a lot of these little side stems are going to shoot soon and have flowers as well. So although it might not have the absolutely spectacular display at the moment, I know that this display will last longer because it's just that bit further behind, whereas the other plants, sometimes they can be a little bit over when you first buy them from the shop. So before I plant up my violas, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to carefully go through this and pick off any of the old flowers and flowers that are just going to go over. This is to make sure that the plant doesn't go to seed. If it does go to seed, then it's not going to put as much energy into its flowers, and it's just going to put its energy into its seed, and then what will happen is it'll go over quite quickly. I'll get less of a flowering display. And it won't grow as large or as impressive. So here I have my first tub. I'm actually going to leave the compost that's in it at the moment. This was for summer bedding last year, but I was quite late with the summer bedding, so this compost hasn't been grown in for too many months. The other reason is spring bedding doesn't really need a lot of feed. It's going to be quite cool temperatures. The growth speed isn't going to be that great. And things like violas and pansies don't need a lot of feed compared with some of the summer bedding plants. Also, it's a waste of compost, as I say, if it's good compost, and I'm only going to be growing them in here for 2 months. What I will do though is put fresh compost in come springtime, and I will actually top this up very slightly because I need a little bit more compost in here, because the level's just kind of compacted down a little bit over the summertime and over the wintertime. But as I say, when it does come to summer, I will replace this with brand new fresh compost, as the summer bedding will be in here for quite a few months and it tends to be a lot heavier feeders. So I'm now just loosening all the compost up, kind of trying to mix in the new compost with the old compost so that it's not too different for the plants. When the plants' roots are growing, it's not like it's, one section is pure new compost, one section is pure old compost. You need to have a good mixture of the two. And I'm just breaking it up a bit because, as I say, it has compacted a bit over the winter and there's a few kind of old roots in here that might need to be taken out as well. Well, that's the compost looking quite loose again. What I will do is I'll plant up just the two sides, and the reason for that, as I said in previous videos, if this hooks over a railing like so there's almost no soil here. There's not even probably an inch of soil, just probably about 1 or 2 centimeters of soil in the middle section, and then the two sides have very deep sections of soil for the roots to grow in. If I scrape with the surface here, you can see there's actually plastic right in the middle, so I can't plant in there. So what I have to do is plant on a row along the front and a row along the back. And as I've got 6 plants here, I'm simply just going to do 3 at the back and 3 at the front. So they're the 6 pansies that I'm going to put in here. Pansies look really good. They've got very good white roots, nice established root systems. They're not overly pot bound. They are a little bit pot bound at the very bottom here, but generally there's a decent spacing of roots, but at the same time the roots aren't unhealthy or sparse, so they're looking very good and this should take off nicely. So I'll just pop them all in the compost now. There we are, so that's my 2 planters planted up. Now I'll briefly explain to you why I've chosen to go with violas and why I go with violas quite a lot during springtime. Violas for me, I find are one of the most successful spring flowers you can have here in Scotland. The reason being, if there is a frost, these will take the frost no problem. They can take probably almost a -5 and still survive. What you will find is often the flowers die off and stop flowering if it gets very cold. But normally in April in Scotland, that's not an issue. And the reason I chose these again is because in Scotland we have quite cold springs. In cold weather a lot of other plants don't seem to grow. A lot of plants, unless it's above 10 degrees, you won't get any growth. Pansies, as well as being able to take frost, they can also grow in low temperatures. So even if it's low temperature, as long as it's above frost and as long as it's sunny, these will be growing. So I'll get some growth out of them. And the final reason is because these continue flowering for a long time and they'll bush out and this should completely fill this whole area within a couple of months. So I'll get a really nice display. I was tempted by some primulas and primroses, but although they give a much better display, I mean, the color is much more intense. You get much better coverage. With a lot of the primroses, you can actually have so many flowers, you can't see the leaves. It's just a complete riot of color. But I find they only last about a month. And then once they finish flowering, they're just leaves. And you can, but they're good because they're perennial. You can grow them year after year, but they generally only give about 1 month of good flowering and that's them finished. Whereas the pansies, if the summer's not too hot, you could actually grow these all summer long and they'll keep flowering. Now, I did actually want to get some wallflowers. What I quite often do with my planter is I put wallflowers along the back, pansies at the front. What tends to happen then is wallflowers grow up above the pansies. The pansies kind of grow over the edge of the side and trail over. And it gives a really nice display. But unfortunately, none of the garden centres around me this year seem to have any wallflowers. I'm not sure the reason for that. They normally sell them in spring and summer, but maybe I was too early, I'm not sure. But normally at this time of year you should be able to get them, as it's already April now. So no wallflowers this year, but I say I'm going with violas. You can go with pansies as well. Pansies are basically the same as violas, but the flowers are much larger. I personally prefer the violas, and the reason for that is because it's quite windy on my balcony and the big flowers of the pansies tend to get broken up a bit with the wind. If you live in a very windy position, then violas are much more hardy than a pansy. Pansies are kind of blow around in the wind and get damaged much more easily. And finally, my Senetti. The reason I love Senettis is they just flower so well and they love the cold weather. They don't have any problems with the cold. The only thing that is a bit different with the Senetti compared with the pansy is it doesn't like frost. So whenever there's a frosty night, I will take my Senetti back inside so it doesn't have any issues with frost damage. but it gives a really good display. Sometimes these flowers so well you can't even see the leaves. I'll show you some photos now of what my spring flowers look like in previous years, and also how stunning the Senetti is when it's completely covered in flowers.